All right, man. Have you ever heard of Dave before?
Dave Chappelle? No, I haven't heard of Dave.
You went for a treat, man. What is going down, world? Welcome to the 40-year-old FUQ Boys podcast. I go by the name Black Pegasus, and I have a very special guest in the house, my main man, DJ Chevy. What's up, fam?
What up, y'all? What's up, bro?
Yeah, man. So if you guys don't know, he's my tour DJ for when I perform. He DJs at a bunch of our concerts. He's one of the main Colorado DJs, DJs all the downtown clubs. But yo, man, this is my bro, man. This is my bro. And I'm in here putting him on to new music and new stuff. So hope you guys enjoy the ride. Everything we do is pretty much a first-time reaction, blind reaction. He's never heard of this.
At all. This already looks like it's going to be dope. He's playing the piano, so.
Yep, man.
Mess with it.
So, yeah, let's get into it. Now, I have seen this, you guys, but it was a long time ago, and it was during a live stream. This is Dave. The song is called Black, and it's live at the Brits in 2020. So we're going to take a little trip back and, Yeah. All right. Like, share, and comments on all the content. But if you really rock with the vibe, subscribe to the damn channel. Here we go. 40.
40-year-old
what?
Boys are back in town. 40. Boys are back in town. 40-year-old
what?
Boys are back in town.
Podcast malt liquor for your ears.
40.
This dude.
Insure.
This dude did a damn hatred plug. People start buying Insure off the racks now. No. You guys, let me get this logo down and pull the video up. I dropped a new music video. It's called Space Invaders, featuring Godemus from Cess Crew. If you guys can check it out, man, give it some views. Trying to get it to 10,000 views and up. Just like you guys helped me with my Planned It music video, you know, support the original content on the channel the same way you do these reactions. And, you know, it means a lot to your boy. So the channel's moving on up, and I appreciate each and every one of y'all who tap in. Try to give y'all fun time, try to find new music, put guests in front of it, and just vibe. So now that we're past 100,000 subs, I want to start doing some new stuff, playing some type of games, you know, just doing some new stuff. So be on the lookout for some more original content. Let's go. So this is Dave, okay? I really don't know his background like that. I reacted to a video called Panic Attack. It was epic as well. But this is Dave, and the song's called Black. And check it out, man. I'm going to bring it back from the beginning because that is just so, like, gives you that theatrical feel. Now, I guess the Brits might be kind of like the Grammys in America or, like,
oh, yeah.
You know, because, like, I'm in like America, that. We have the Grammys. I think in Canada, they have the Junos. So okay. I'm guessing
something
the Brits
similar.
Is some type of musical award. So it's
okay.
Probably higher prestigious than BET Awards.
Facts. Or the MTV Awards and stuff like that. Yeah.
So let's get it. Here we go.
Black is beautiful, black is excellent. Black is pain, black is joy, black is evident. Working twice as hard as the people you know you're better than, cause you need to do double what they do so you can level them. Black is so much deeper than just African American. Our heritage been severed, you never got to experiment with family trees, cause they teach you about famine and greed. Show you pictures of our fam on their knees. Tell us we used to be barbaric, we had actual queens. Black is watching child soldiers getting killed by the children, feeling sick so quick, this could have happened to me. Mummy watching, telling stories about your dad and your niece. Listen, the blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice. Kid dies, the blacker the killer, the sweeter the news. And if he's white, you give him a chance, he's ill and confused. If he's black, he's probably armed, you see him and shoot. Look, Black is growing up around the barbershop. Mommy says stay away from trouble, you're in yard a lot. Studying for ages, appreciating the chance you got, cause black is in your blood and you ain't even got the heart to stop. Black is stepping in for your brothers because your father's gone. Standing by your children when you haven't proven karma wrong. Black is doing all of the above, then going corner shop. Trying to help a lady cross the road to have her walking off. Black is growing up around your family and making it. Being forced to leave the place you love because there's hating it. People say you're faking it, never stay for changing it. But black is being jealous, you'd be dead if you had stayed in it. Black is struggling to find your history and tracing it. You don't know the truth about your race because they're erasing it. Black has got a really sour flavor, here's a taste of it. But black is all I know, there ain't a thing that I would change in it.
Facts. People don't really realize like how, sorry, it kind of choked me up a little bit. It's just like, yeah, like watching it and like someone actually using their platform to put it, like, you know, like if it's something like the Grammys, the Brits and stuff like that, that is crazy because there's always that struggle that with slavery and the history. It's like, obviously if he's in the Brits, like they're going to be like, well, that was an American thing. Slavery was like, yeah, well, slavery was everywhere. But it's just like, people always want you to forget the past. And it's like, bro, like that was only like a couple generations ago,
yeah,
for African-Americans and stuff like that. And that's what's crazy. It's like, we still are affected by that daily, just by the way we look. And then the internal struggle, which I'm pretty sure you've gotten it too, with you being light skinned, like either it's like you're too black to be with the white crowd, but then you're too white to be with the black crowd. And I've always gotten that, yeah, you know? So, you know, black is beautiful. And it's like, you know, a lot of people don't see it, but cause they see the more negative side,
yeah,
of everything. But that's the agenda that it seems like the media and people want to like post. Cause we were just talking about why that they're saying that there hasn't been a hip hop album hit number one,
yeah,
this year in 2023. And it's like, well, why not?
Well, nah, the music has been kind of rat. It's kind
well, that's
of
what I'm saying. Yeah. But it's like, you see how they push more of, like, this is no hate to anybody that likes, you know, the ratchet stuff. But it's like, you know, WAP, Pound Town, or just like some kind of just stupid, like, just something that it don't have no substance. Like, where's the Kendricks? You know, like, obviously, Andre 3000 got to put out an album, which I think he's going to. But it's just like, you know, the message isn't being pushed like it was like in like the 80s, 90s, or even the 2000s. Like, we don't have a public enemy. We don't have anything like that. So just to hear, you know, obviously this was in 2020, you know, everything that happened then, you know, George Floyd and so many, dude, there's just so many people just, you know, getting, you know, killed by police or just by people being racist or, oh, you rang my doorbell and you're African-American and bang, don't even like, it's just so crazy, and other people don't have to deal with that. And it's like minorities, especially blacks and Hispanics, have to deal with this on a regular basis.
Yeah, well, I think it's a complex conversation, right?
For sure.
Because what he's saying, there's a lot of truth to it. But we've come so far, let's speak as America, because actually I think Britain ended slavery first. I think they were the first ones to end slavery.
Oh, yeah, probably,
like,
yeah.
It's kind of wild, but there's things, it's complex in the state of, like, you see certain things happen, right?
Right.
But then also in the age of social media, I also think they magnify certain racial events to charge the public, right?
Oh, for sure.
Because we remember the LA riots with Rodney King and stuff like that, and that was effed up. But it ain't like everything, in my opinion, has gotten better to a degree. But what I would like
it's
to
not
highlight
the same, but
is, like, there's this weird thing because me, politically, sometimes I lean a little right, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm more like a moderate, right? But certain left-leaning ideas where I'm like, yo, that's real. And this is what's funny. If you lean into, like, let's say the Republican space or conservative space, mm-hmm, which I identify with a lot of different things from, you know, like they seem to be wanting to fight, you know, censorship, and they're about like 2A and stuff like that, which I really gravitate to. But they're not willing to have a conversation about like certain racial things. It just gets, the lines get so blurry.
There's so many layers to everything.
And I struggle because it's like, I don't know where to sit or fit, because this is what I like, the beginning of this track, man. Hopefully this reaction don't go off the rails, but the beginning of it, he's saying these things, these struggles, right, that right. happened in history. Now, I believe some of that affect us to this day, but not as much as we would think. And what was interesting right, for sure. is he segued into having to leave the place you love because there's hate in it.
Exactly.
He's yeah. not talking about white people. He's talking about the black community.
Oh, no. Yeah, 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 yeah.
No, that's and like I know you know. Yeah, yeah. I'm just highlighting that because that's what choked me up. Because when I throw concerts for a living, and yeah. you know who effed that up.
Yeah.
Like, not trying to be that. I'm just saying in my personal experience, yeah. me and him, we do concerts together.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, I don't even want to get into that. But at the same time, there's this weird thing, like this propaganda machine that has been churning since the 40s, since the 60s, that, hey, you know, black people are this way. And then Hollywood just put all these lead roles. You're always the thug, right? They're trying to change it. But then it's like now, instead of putting strong, black, straight, heterosexual men, it's like they're like weak. They want to change their... It's just weird. Yeah, like, it's so weird. But we live a lot of times, our community will sometimes live up to the profiling and the stereotype.
Yeah, for sure.
And I think it's up to us to listen to something like this, understand our Facts. History, not let our history emotionally trigger us, break the cycle of stereotypes, mm-hmm. not asking for a handout. I don't need you to level the playing field for me. I'm going to work Facts. Harder. I'm going to be the best I can be. I'm going to release these emotional triggers and build the community, and then also reach outward and not have this weird angst to other races and things like that, because there's right, a lot right. of things plaguing us as humans. Because when right. I think of the black struggle, there is a struggle there, but there is also like a lot of immigrants that came to America that dealt with things. And sometimes people in yeah. a poor class might deal with something that someone in the racial class. So
it's like they had the yeah. a similar struggle.
Yeah. It's,
and I mean,
it's
when
just
I was saying,
complex. It's more than yeah. a 4 minute video or a reaction. Sure. We could talk about this for 3 hours and just go
yeah,
back right. and forth.
Yeah. We've done that before, you know, going to go off to shows. And like that, I didn't mean like, you know, like with the struggle, like it's solely, you know, we're blaming slavery or Jim Crow era and yeah. stuff like that. All this racism. There's a lot that, you know, us as a black community could do to help each other and help ourselves.
Yes.
And, you know, it's crazy because in 2020, I did this Black Lives Create event. Mm-hmm. So it was a bunch of black vendors. There was like a story time that was led by, you know, a black woman. And then I was DJing. So I was like, and I was kind of like on the fence because there was, you know, it's great to have support from other cultures, other races and stuff like that. But I think it was actually thrown by like white folks. And there's nothing wrong with that, but it's just kind of like, why didn't we throw that? And I'm not 100% sure. I just know, like, you know, the people that booked me,
bro,
you know, like, didn't look like me. And I just thought that was weird. And it's like, when we do certain community events, what happens? It's like, there's always seems like there's some kind of violence or negative, not all the time, but it's yeah. just like, we've tried, like, it's like we do things and then it's like people like want to still act tough, or instead of, you know, being unified, they're like, oh, you're wearing a blue hat.
Yeah.
And they have to start like, bro, we're here for a reason.
Yeah.
And I mean, this isn't just the black community. I've seen this happen in other communities
yeah.
as well.
Yeah, I've been to
it's more prominent.
A biker bar, dudes are getting shanked. Like,
yeah,
bro.
And it's like there's violence and all kinds of yeah. things. And
but we're discussing it because this is yeah, our community we came from, it. We grew up in. And I sometimes struggle talking about this publicly because then it feels odd when you're critical of your community
yeah,
and then
it's like,
other people jump in and start pointing.
And then it goes like another way. Yeah. Like, you guys are all like this. I was like, no, we're talking about this specific one jackass that did yeah. this and it ruined the whole party. Yeah, ruined the whole event. But that it goes to,
I think it's an open conversation we all need to have yeah. and not steer away from, but this is beautiful. And he's saying a lot of real stuff.
For sure.
And, people know I try to stay away from what I call the woke nonsense, which woke was actually a positive thing. Now it's all like this,
yeah, it's kind of,
you know,
like weird.
It's like what it
started as, and then it's just something different.
I just try to take on things that will make me stronger and not weaker mentally and in every aspect. And I really like that, dude. This is a beautiful song, and let's just get into it. We'll keep vibing. But yeah, man, I got choked up when he said, "Knowing you have to leave the place you love because there's hate in it." Yeah, it's just like, it's almost like you have to turn your back on your people just to survive, because where the, a lot of the places I'm from or have been to, it's just so cutthroat, man. And even this neighborhood that we record in, I have to get out of here, man. There was a shooting up the street. Five people got shot. I'm like, bro, what the?
Dude, you know what I'm saying? And before you play this again, because, and what we're talking about is just like, you know, because like everything he was saying, as like it was choking me up. And then yeah, that did too, because it's like the hate that comes, because
you
from
love your people,
your own
bro.
People, because we're bro. No matter what. I think you were telling me this.
All people, but you know, it's like you love we
like to we're more drawn to like our people that look like us.
Yeah, we're tribalism.
Yeah, tribalism.
All people are like that.
Yeah, so yeah. It's so like, it's like, and then it's like when your tribe is like, look at me, and they're like, well, you. I watch NASCAR, so y'all are already gonna, as soon as the season, it's like, it's gonna be like, oh, well, that's a white sport. You know, there's only one black driver, and they call him Bubba Smollett now because of a fake noose, a noose that he didn't even find that they blamed on him, but that's another story. There, he gets a lot of hate now. They loved him until he used his voice, like the NASCAR community, which is mainly Southern white folks.
Yeah.
And they loved him, but as soon as he used his voice, they hated him. And
yeah,
same with like Lewis Hamilton, stuff like that. But like,
I don't know enough of the story to go there or back. Yeah. I'm familiar with him, but I'm not a NASCAR dude. I don't know the story.
Yeah,
I've and heard conservatives talk about him.
Confederate flags is
left.
Gone now, and it's like people just made a big deal about nothing that he really had nothing to do with. But what I was saying about the whole community like hating, it's like, where did Young Dolph? Where did he get killed at? His neighborhood, getting cookies for his mom.
Dude, Nipsey Hussle.
Yeah, Nipsey, out front of his own shop, in Crenshaw, like a shop he put in that neighborhood
to
for
better
a reason.
The neighborhood.
And then they took him out.
Yeah.
You know, and then PNB Rock.
Bro,
it's like there's so much hate. And that's what we mean by it's like there's you know, our community, we need to support and embrace each other. But then there's that violence or that haters gonna hate thing. It's like somebody always has something.
What
negative.
I'm trying to tell you is my life experience, and even telling you I have to get out of this neighborhood. So my head's on a swivel. So if I have to protect myself and try to look at things and make sure I'm safe, and then stereotypically I'm seeing things that you see on TV, so then I recognize this pattern.
Right,
why would I get mad for other races recognizing that same pattern? Facts. Do you see that?
It's just weird how it explodes, though, and it's like always with...
It makes me go crazy.
Mainly with minorities, it just goes crazy, and that's what you see. You don't see this.
Yeah, we can all do better, man.
So, yeah,
and,
no,
And we're not the only ones doing
blah,
blah, but it's just, you know, it is what it is. Let's see how he keeps going. I remember this was deep. I forgot how deep it was.
It makes you think like so many, because we just went off on that for what? Like
probably went off like 8-9 minutes. Yeah.
So I mean, it's complex.
Your race, because they're erasing it. Black has got a really sour flavor. Here's a taste of it, but black is all I know. There ain't a thing that I would change in it.
You could tell too.
Look, black isn't a single color, man, there's shades to it. Her hair's straight and thick, but mine's got waves in it. Black is not divisive, they've been lying and I'm hating it. Black has never been a competition, we're all making it. Black is deadly. Black is when you're freezing in your home and you can't get sleep, but never feeling empty, cause you got 20 cousins in your country living stress-free, walking for their water daughter wrapped inside a bed sheet. Black is distant, it's representing countries that never even existed while your grandmother was living. Black is my Ghanaian brother, reading into scriptures, doing research on his lineage, finding out that he's Egyptian. Black is people naming your countries and what they trade most, Coast of Ivory, Gold Coast, and the Grain Coast. But most importantly, to show how deep all of this pain goes, West Africa, Benin, they call the Slave Coast. Black is so confusing, could the culture there in love with it? Take our features when they want and have their fun with it. Never seem to help with all the things you know will come with it. Loud in our laughter, silent in our suffering. Black is being strong inside the face of defeat. Poverty made me a beast. I battled the law in the streets. Well, you struggle, but your struggle ain't a struggle like me. Well, how could it be when your people gave us the odds that we beat? I mean, bloody hell. What about our brothers that are stuck in jail that couldn't bust the bell? They held a burden, got to live with it. Black is being guilty until proven that you're innocent. Black is saying free all of my people stuck inside of prison cells. Think it's funny we ain't got nothing to say to them. Unconditional love is strange to them, it's amazing. Black has really got the sweetest flavor, here's a taste of it. But black is all I know, there ain't a thing that I would change in it. It is racist, whether or not it feels racist. The truth is our prime ministers are real racist. They say you should be grateful we're the least racist. I say the least racist is still racist. And if somebody hasn't said it, equality's a right, it doesn't deserve credit. Now if you don't wanna get it, then you're never gonna get how the news treats Kate versus how they treated Meghan. Rest in peace, Jack Merritt, you're my brother in arms. There's tears in our eyes and love in our hearts. We never had the same background, culture, color or past, but you devoted your life to giving others a chance. And for that, I'm so taken aback, because he gave us all a voice. I have to say it for Jack. As a young black man that's seen paper and crack, giving tougher sentences, it's just paper and cracks. All he would want is unity, funding for communities, equal opportunities, people under scrutiny, no more immunity, way less hatred, more conservation, less deforestation, we want rehabilitation. Now that would be amazing, but Grenfell victims still need accommodation, and we still need support for the Windrush generation, reparations for the time our people spent on plantations. I'm done.
I mean, that he said it. I mean, it was just deep, and it does have different meanings. Like what we were saying, it's not just one certain thing. And that's the thing. We all want the equality and the unity and stuff like that. But it's like weird how like some people think we want equality by a handout. Yeah, like I don't want nothing from nobody, because I saw something. Oh man, I don't remember. It was like some billionaire or something. Like it was something about shining, like white people shining black people's shoes, and yeah. I get what he was trying to say, but he did it though. It's like when, I don't know how to say this. Like when some white people want to show their I guess like to be apologetic to the black community.
Yeah,
it's like they do too much. Like, remember when something, when Juneteenth, when they took a knee or something, yeah, and they were all wearing the thing around like Nancy Pelosi or whoever it was in the White. I'm like, what are y'all doing? We didn't ask for that. We just don't shoot us, like, just because, and treat us equally.
That's, yeah, it's just black pander. And yeah, I believe we've,
yeah, facts.
We've came a long way. You know, in his little part where he starts going racist this and everything is racist. I don't always agree with that. There are things going on. Mm-hmm. And when you start looking at history and starting with tribalism and then just the slave trade of massive amounts of people being in the slavery, when we talk about America, it is interesting because after slavery, black folks were treated very poorly. I mean, beyond poorly. And so, yeah, like rising up above that, you know, I'm not saying that wasn't a dark part of our history, but right now there's just so many things. It's like this weird balance I try to keep, because I know there's so much opportunity here, even though there we can do better and there's nonsense.
Oh,
so,
for sure.
But I wanted to read this because, you know, I go back and forth. I feel like I'm, you know, F the politics. But sometimes, you know, some of my brothers and sisters who follow me, who are more right-leaning Republican or conservative, there's this big divisive nature with them versus the woke. And I understand it. I understand, you know, boycotting, right, Target for what's going on right now. There's a lot of those things that I personally don't agree with, and I ride with them on.
No,
but
for sure.
I also want them to see the valid points that are from the left, which I would think he's a little more left-leaning. This is a dictionary, my guy, from 1920. I want to read the definition.
Jeez, it's like literally falling apart. Yeah.
I want to read the definition of black before we go. Oh, so this is the definition of black in this 1920 dictionary. Destitute of light, of the darkest hue, opposed to white, enveloped in darkness, dismal, gloomy, or forbidden, destitute or moral light or goodness, atrocious, evil, calamitous, threatening, clouded with anger, sullen, the darkest color, the opposite of white, a black pigment or dye, a negro, mourning, to make black, blacken, apply, blackening to. So I want to read that, and this is coming from someone who's not subscribing to all the, you know, crazy racial narratives.
Right.
But the truth is, this is the truth. This is 1926, new dictionary of the English language.
Okay? That's crazy.
So, like, people can, like, when you have a whole generation of people, when this is the definition mm-hmm. of black, atrocious. Mm-hmm. Like, it's just like that. Like, black mm-hmm. is just a color, bro. White is just a color. You know what I'm saying? If you want to describe the color ring or whatever, cool. Mm-hmm. But to be like destitute of this, evil, atrocious, like, so that's propaganda. Now, what I would like to say is if they did this in the dictionary, 2020 happened. You guys know how I feel about 2020. What happened in Google? They changed the definition of the, they changed the definition of a lot of things, my guy. I can't get into it on YouTube, but think about this. I showed you the proof of how they use words, terminology, statements to change your perception.
Oh, for sure.
Just the color black in here is like, oh, it's like, okay, so everything color, that's black is Darth Vader? Really?
Yeah.
You see what
it's
I'm
like,
saying?
Like, it's like it's, there's no beauty in it and all that. And then if you looked at the color white in the dictionary, it probably says purity or something like that.
Possibly.
Any, you know what I mean? Just, it's
I
like
say
the
that
the
just to be like, even though I don't subscribe to all these ideas of trying to create these racial barriers and make things even more hyperbolic, there are still things that have been done and narratives that have been spun. I just showed an example, and I hope people could just take that. And I'm not tied to this. I had to liberate myself of all of these things because it made me weaker. It's easy to be like, oh, this happened because I'm black. This isn't fair.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, life isn't fair, and it is what it is. I got the cards that I was dealt, and that's just my personality. I'm not saying you have to deal with your makeup the other way. I think it's cool when people are open to these conversations.
Right.
And I always want to be empathetic and compassionate to someone who might have an emotional trigger linked to something race or something class or whatever the case may be.
Right.
And I understand my heritage and history, but at the same time, I had to cut my strings, man, because I was a puppet. I was a puppet for the Matrix, and that's just where I stand. But that was a little... I read that on the last time I reacted to that because I just keep that dictionary in here because you can learn a lot from old encyclopedias, old dictionaries, because the thing is they can't change that. Google can change the algorithm. They can censor me on YouTube, but they can't change books. They can't change what they wrote. That's why they want to burn books.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
And
that's, of course.
I just want access to what people really think.
They want to eliminate certain histories and stuff like that. So it's like it goes back to, you don't want people knowing this certain thing.
And it goes both ways, too, because they want to create these radical things that, it goes both ways. They want to recreate history and be like start adding stuff like. And it goes both ways. I'm not just saying like, let's say, this white person tried to erase black history, but then you'll have black people trying to insinuate things in these new books, stating things were maybe went this way or their own interpretation on how we're affected now when there's no proof. There's just a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah.
And I had to cut the strings, man. I had to cut the strings.
I think there's like people that believe like the Holocaust didn't happen or something.
Yeah, yeah.
I was just hearing about that. I'm like, okay, so did 9/11 not happen? Like, we know these things happen, but it's just weird how, like, certain people, then they have a following. That's what throws me off. There's so much in books that prove that certain things happen and things were a certain way, and then one person's like, oh, no, this didn't happen. No, absolutely not.
Yeah.
And then people are like, follow so much. I'm like, what's in the water that's just making people just like, we're doing this now. So
what's crazy is you're going down a slippery slope because everything you're starting to talk about will get you kicked off YouTube.
let's not do that then. We got to get you that little.
I mean, it's real. It's like, I actually like these conversations, man. Like, this is all we used to do on the pod, but for some reason these reactions trigger the algorithm. And I don't know what it is. People, I don't know, man. Me and Don, we could talk for 3 hours on this subject because it's way more complex and deep than just being like, oh, this, that, and the other. And I'm starting to learn that. And I also learned they position these racial things to create tension between, like, it's never to solve the problem.
Mm-hmm.
It's never like they don't really want to create a level playing field. It's literally, these things cause more divisiveness. Like, you don't, anyways, I could go into the
I hate all that,
policies but, get kind of wild. Like, the best suited person for a job should get the job. And, but at the same time, like the person hiring shouldn't stereotype someone and be like, and I'm going to give it to them when they're like equal. You see what I'm saying?
Especially,
I get it, but that, I'm like, yo.
That's why, yo, my name, you know, is kind of just generic. You know, it's Michael. So it's just like.
he's a diversity hire.
You know, like they would never know. And then the way I speak, you know, right on this mic, I might sound a little, you know, what up. But, you know, it's just crazy. You know, like the way people will look at you, perceive you. And you may get a job based not get a job based on your name, or if you do a phone interview, then you walk in and you're like, oh, shit. Yeah. Like, who is this? But yeah, anyways, yo. Yeah.
All right, you guys. That was Dave Black. Beautiful. Got the conversation rolling. Thought I'd do something a little different with Chevy on that one. Let's get it. You know what it is. 40.
Thank you for being some man. 40 years down the road back again. 40. FUQ. Boy.